Hello all, welcome to this online workshop on empowerment through digital technology and e-learning methodologies organized by SNDT Women's University, Mumbai in collaboration with Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Noida, Institute of Engineering and Technology, Greater Noida. I am Shikha Minani, Assistant Professor, PGDAV College, University of Delhi. Okay, so let us get started with OBS or Open Broadcaster Software. It's a very nice software where you can make videos and many other things, and you can share it with your students or with your colleagues or your friends. So let us get started. For that, type in your browser Open Broadcaster Software. Now when I type this obsproject.com is opened. I'll just click on this, and depending upon the system that I have, whether it is Windows, Mac or Linux, I can download it, and this is how the OBS screen would appear, which we'll just see after we download it. These are the sponsors and these are the unlimited features that are available on this excellent freeware, which is OBS. So let us get started. When you download OBS, the icon would look something like this. This is the OBS studio which we would be using today. So let us open this, and this is the main home page or the screen which would appear. It has few divisions. This black screen is nothing but it is your stage, where whatever you are doing, it would appear here. Whether you want to type some text, you want to show some image, you want to insert any PPT, all that would be done here. Below, we have different sections. The first is called the scenes. Now, scenes means these are like different chapters of a book. So, if you want to have multiple scenes in your video, you can have different scenes, and in each scene, you can insert different material. Like in one scene, you can have your face recording. In one scene, you can have the PPT. In one scene, you can have some YouTube video being played. And in one scene, you can just simply write some text. And using all these combinations, you can make a very nice video. This is the sources. Sources means what all you can insert in the OBS. So we can have the audio, we can have the text, we can have the image, we can have the webcam, we can have our screen capture also. So all that we would be doing using this sources. This is the audio mixer which we would be using to mix the audios for different scenes. This is the control, which is very important, and there are two types of control. We have the streaming. You must have seen how there are certain videos which are streamed live on YouTube, Facebook, etc. So OBS is one such encoder which can be used to stream live on the YouTube, which we learn in our today's video. The second button is for the recording. If you want to record any video, we need to use this particular button. Now let us go to this another important setting, which is file. When I click on this file on the top, the first button is show recordings. So whatever recordings you have done using this OBS would be automatically saved here. If you want to change the path, that too can be done. For that, let us go to settings. When we go to settings, we have these different options which are very important. The first is the general option. Here you can select the language, which obviously I am choosing to English. You can select the theme. So right now the black screen is appearing because this is the default dark screen of the OBS. If you want to change it, that too can be done. So you can see how the screen has changed to a little bluish color. That is because of the settings that I have changed. Let us go back and see. This is the stream which we would be using for streaming live on the YouTube, and the hotkeys too we would be using. So this is about the settings that would be used in today's video. Let us go to sources now. So if you want to add any sources, what we have to do is we have to click on this plus sign to add any source. But prior to that, let us see this scenes. there is by default one scene already in our OBS, but this scene name is looking very awkward. So what we'll do is, we'll just go to scene and right click and we'll give it a name. So we'll rename it and I can rename. So I know that in my first scene I have the PPT. I can also insert different scenes and I can have my web, my PPTs, my face recording, etc. Let us go back to sources and click on this plus sign. When I click on this plus sign, I have these various options which can be used. The first is the audio input capture. So whatever I'm speaking using my microphone would be recorded in the OBS system. If I click on this audio output capture, then what will happen is whatever voice is coming out of my system, it would be recorded. So let me add this audio input capture. If I want to add the source, I have to just click on this. This box would appear and I click on OK. Again, I click on OK and you can see that my audio input capture is here. Right. Now let us add something extra. Now next is the browser. Now what is this browser? By using this, you can have any YouTube video being played or being inserted in your video. So let me click on this browser. I click on OK and this big box is appearing. By default, already in the URL, you can see that this OBS icon or OBS video is there by default. So if you want to add any other video, what we have to do is, I'll just go to my YouTube channel. And from there, I'll take this link, I'll copy it and I'll paste it over here. Right. So this is what we want to do. Shut down source when not visible. Refresh browser. So you can also change these settings. I'll click on OK. And this is how the video would automatically gone. If I click on it again, the video would come back. Let us see that. So you can also do this. Now I don't want browser to appear here because it is creating noise. So if I want to remove any source, just click on that and click on this minus sign. So it would be automatically removed. Click on yes. Okay. Now let us add other source, which is the color source. Now by default, the background color was white. If I want to select any color, you can click on that color and click on OK and OK again. So now my background color is not white. My background color would be something like this. And on this, I can also write something. So if I want to write something, what I have to do is, I will again go back to plus sign and I will add text. Again, I'll click on OK and this another box would open where in the text I can write any text that I want. I can change the font size, right? I can go down and I can also change the font color. If you want to change the font color, that too can be done, right? So this is how you can make various changes to your text. If you want to drag it down, you can bring it down. But when you are doing any change, you have to make sure that right now this text is having a red boundary and my screen is having a blue boundary. So whatever is there in the red boundary, that particular thing is activated. So if I am dragging this, the text is moving because that is activated. If I click on the background and now if I move, you can see that the screen is moving. So you have to be very particular about as to what you want to move. I can also increase or decrease the size of my text by doing this. Alright. Now, if I want to add another source, I want to have an image. So I'll go to plus and I'll go to image. Remember, there are two things. One is image and the other is image slideshow. Here we are doing the image because image would insert just one image. So we'll click on image, we'll click on OK and we'll browse it from our device. Let me have this particular image here. I'll click on OK. This is the image and I can make it a little big. Just a second. So this is how my image can be dragged. If you want your whole image to be there on the full page, you have to right click it and you go to transform. And when I go to transform and I go to stretch to screen, then what will happen? The whole image would be there on the screen. But I don't want that to happen because I want my text to be here. So this is how I'll place my image. Now let us go back to text and see what different things we can do with the text. If I want that my text should keep on scrolling on my screen, then for that click, right click and go to filters. In the filters, you can see that welcome is here. It means that we have selected the right thing and we click on this plus. Now this plus asks you, what do you want to do with this text? I want it to scroll. So I'll click on scroll, I'll click on OK, and there are two types of scroll that we have. Either it can move horizontally, you can see like this, or it can also move vertically. So what I want to do is, I want it to move horizontally, so I'll just change this and I'll close it. So you can see that the text has started moving like this. You can also change its direction. The same thing can be applied to the image also. For that, I need to activate the image. So I'll right click the image. I'll go to filters. You can see that now here is the image. I'll click on plus. Again, scroll. OK. And you can decide how you want your image to move. So this is how you can control it. If you want to close it, then you simply close the eye. And the image won't be there. If you want to close the text, you can do that also. So this is the first video where we simply introduced the image and the text along with the scroll option. In our next video, we'll see how we can record using our face or the webcam and how we can insert the PPT. Thank you so much.